Alright, what's up everyone? Welcome to the GiveWave Studios Deadshot Knee Pad Tutorial. For anyone who bought the kit on Etsy, thank you, appreciate the support. These are all the parts that you should be receiving with everything, and once everything is put together, should have something that looks similar to this. Now on mines, I have certain tools here at the shop, so I was able to put rivets and different types of stuff in here for the this that closes with snaps, but Velcro will do just as good, and that's how we're going to build this kit today. Alright, so first thing I'm going to do is grab my barge. I'll have a link in the description of where I get this on Amazon, so you guys can purchase the same stuff too if you're interested. So the first thing I'm going to do is kind of start with the easy stuff. Literally, we're going to put some glue on this, put some glue on this, and then stick them all together. We have a total of, I believe, 2, 4, 6, 8 of them to do. So it should be pretty quick. You get it done in about 20 minutes. You can also do this with hot glue or spray adhesive, whatever you have laying around. I find that the barge is a more permanent solution, as it's kind of like heat proof and sweat proof. So it'll make sure that it lasts a little longer. All right, so I'm just gonna speed through this process and skip on to the next step. So as we're putting these together, you just want to make sure that, you know, you get enough glue on the corners, because that's usually the first place it's going to start peeling if it does. So however you decide to do this, with barge or with spray adhesive or hot glue, just make sure that your edges really get the bulk of the glue. And just start from one corner and gradually work your way to the other. And that'll usually make sure that everything is aligned, and then just squeegee it all the way down to the tip. Now, if you do this with barges, you'll end up with like a little bit of glue in the middle. It's easily fixed enough. You can grab like a set of keys or anything else that you can have, and just like detach those threads. And there we have that. All right, now that we got our tabs out of the way, what we're gonna do is start heating up our knee pads themselves. So this is the base pad, and this is kind of like the detail that's gonna go over it. What we're gonna do is take the heat gun, we're gonna heat this up real quick. Gonna grab our heat gun, turn that puppy on. Is make sure that the side that has the line, that's your outside, the side that doesn't is your inside.
So we're gonna heat this on both sides. Imagine. About 15 seconds on either side. Don't stay on it for too long, you don't want to burn the foam. Also, you can also do this with a hairdryer. It'll take a little longer, but it is just as effective. If you don't have a heat gun at home. Alright.
So that's nice and heated. And what you can do is literally take your knee, move this, and use your knee to kind of get a nice curve going inside of your piece. Now I have a tool here to do this, so I don't need to use my knee, but I just wanted to show you guys that, you know, even if you don't have tools to do this type of stuff, you can always find a way around it. Sometimes I use my elbows or even like any type of round object I can find around the shop or the house. So see, now we have like this nice curve that's gonna sit quite nicely on our knee once we put it on. All right, so we're gonna do that for the other parts, and then we're gonna put everything together. All right. So now that we have all of our shapes nice and heated up, the way that we're gonna connect them is like this. So again, this piece at the top here, it's kind of like the top tier of the knee. There are two lines that go around, kind of like a little border edge there. Where they end is where it meets the larger knee pad piece. And also the smaller end of the knee pad is the top, the larger end is the bottom. All right, so that's a good way for you guys to know. And then once you have it there, I would grab yourself a pen or Apple pen and just trace where that meets there so you know exactly where to put your glue and where it needs to go. I would even, right, line it up. Once you have it lined up and you figure it's nice and centered, not only would I put a line at the top there, but I'll also put a line here at the bottom on the back. In case you're using contact cement, you know exactly where to put the contact cement on both pieces. All right. Once we have these two pieces glued together, I'm not going to put these on just yet. You can just, you know, glue everything on and be like, all right, I have my piece, plasti dip it, and then start painting by hand. But I like to use aerosol spray, so I'm gonna keep these separate only because they're a different color. And then I can weather them separately, and when it's all said and done, I can glue them back on. All right, so that's what we're gonna do for the next part. The time lapse, you guys saw me heating these up. I wasn't actually heating them up. My heat gun has two settings. It just has like just blowing regular air and actually blowing hot air. So I was just doing the regular air just to speed up the drying process a little bit. I wouldn't suggest heating up the barge as you're doing this, only because it's just gonna make it liquidy again. That's not what you want. You want it to have a certain level of tack. All right, so I'm slowly bringing these two together, making sure I line them up properly and that they're nice and centered. I kind of missed on that one. It's all right. Okay, so here we go. Looking at it straight on, and all right, done. I'm committed. It's there. It's not going nowhere. That's it. Can't go back. There's no going back. All right. We have a nice first piece. Now we're going to go ahead and plasti dip these parts and paint them and then put the whole thing back together. And then we'll get back to these because we're going to be putting the straps through it. All right. So, time lapse time. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. Objective reached. All right. So I'm gonna spray these guys down and plasti dip. Probably gonna pick up this and then put it. There we go. All right, we're gonna let that dry for about 15 minutes. We'll be back. Plasti dip came out nice and smooth. I'm gonna apply this paint. This is from Rust-Oleum. It is a metallic and it is called Carbon Mist. Let's go. And for our other parts here, we're gonna use this one, which is a Valspar. It's like a flat, it's kind of like a, I don't know what they call this color, but it's like a dark, smoky red, which we're gonna use for the armored parts. We're ready. Alright, so now we got all of our parts all painted up. We have a nice finish with the carbon mist on the inner part of the knee pad. And then the nice, very dark red for the little detail pieces. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to use a wash of black paint, which is literally a little bit of black paint mixed with a little bit of water. Literally a capful should be more than enough to do this part. And I'm just gonna like really sloppily just kind of weather the whole thing. So put paint down, take paint off almost right away. And this stuff really kind of depends on how diluted your paint is. You might do it and find that you've taken all of it off. Just add a little bit more paint to the mix and make it just a little bit gunkier. All right, we have a nice look to that. So you can tell the difference already. And so you kind of have that dirtied up a little bit. We're gonna do the same thing here. Right, because you don't want this to look even at all, right? Because it's dirt, it's grime, it should be random. Okay. Alright, I'm liking how this is looking. Getting some more. And now what we're going to do is do a little bit of highlight. I use this. This is Rub and Buff. It's like the pewter color. You can also do just like silver acrylic paint. Or spray some spray paint on a piece of plastic and use a brush, just kind of like dry brush it a little bit. I like using this with just a little bit on the fingers, and I'm just gonna kind of go over the edges and just kind of pick and choose the places that I feel like would have had a little bit of wear and tear to it. Not too shabby.
Okay. Now that that's done, I'm gonna go ahead and do the same to this piece. Don't do too much on this one either, just a little bit on the edges, kind of like at the bottom of the knee. Most likely that would get scuffed up a little bit more than any other part. A couple of things just kind of going across. Nothing too fancy. Alright. So got that out of the way.
Now I'm going to do these pieces. So I should have received enough of these for all of the holes. So what we're going to do is, well, I have this tool. This is a hole puncher. But if you have like a toothpick or something like that, that you can kind of poke a hole through dead center of this, just kind of like widen it out a little bit or something like that, you should be able to force your piece through in and out of the other side. It's coming. There it is. Ah, lost it. There we go. All right, and then you should have something like this. This makes my job a lot easier, so I'm just gonna use this for the rest of the tutorial. But you get the idea. Right. I'm gonna grab our eyelets, start putting those into our part. Just like that, okay? And because we painted it first, there should be enough of the plastic dip in the paint, just really holding this in by friction. But if you really wanted to make sure that this didn't separate, you can always push it past a little bit. I don't know if you can see it. Push it past a little bit and just hit it with super glue or something like that. Crazy glue, super glue, Loctite, to just make sure it doesn't pop out on you at any point. All right, so I'm gonna grab these from our example, salvage those and keep this going. All right, the parts are ready. So now what I'm gonna do is place it over the knee pad and just kind of get a general feel where everything falls, nice and centered. And just grab a Apple pen. Just very lightly kind of put an outline of where all of this falls. In my case, this is really critical because I use the barge. I don't want the glue to go past a certain point because, you know, we have a nice paint job to preserve. And yeah, more or less. All right, just gonna apply some hot glue. Well, you can use hot glue. I'm gonna do the barge and I'm gonna stick that on, and I'm gonna do the same thing for this side. All right, my two pieces are nice and dry now. I'm gonna bring everything back together. Let's start from my top line. And remember, we just go from one edge to the other, following our outline, like that, and down, and pluck, squeeze that in, make sure that's not going anywhere. Now that we got this part out of the way, we're gonna do the same thing for this. I'm gonna put this down here, line it up, make sure it's nice and centered. And then, pineapple pen, just trace that out. All right, I don't know if you guys can see it, but I have an outline there, so that's where I'm gonna put my glue, and I'm gonna put this in. And dry now on both sides. I'm gonna go ahead and place our piece. We're gonna start again from one corner, get it down. Really want to make sure these sit flush against that edge. Oh. All right, we're looking good. And then now we're gonna do these parts, little straps. All right, so for this next part, we're gonna need to do a little bit of self-measuring. So you're gonna take your completed piece, you know, put it over your kneecap area, right? Making sure that your kneecap is kind of like nice and centered to the part here, because this comes a little above the kneecap. And you're gonna grab your elastic waistband and go from here. To the other side. Now you should have enough to fit your knee, because I send this with a lot of slack, so, but you decide how tight you want it to be. And you don't want it to be too tight. You want it to be good enough that it won't slide up or down, because if you have it too tight, you could potentially, like, you know, just rip these or pull these off, because literally these are only going to be held on by glue at this point. Unless you have some sort of a riveting machine that you want to use, then you can go ahead and do that. So what we're going to do is slide this into our piece. Actually, we're going to do this the other way around, this way, so that our seam line with the glue doesn't show. So it's going to look like this. All right, so we're going to do that for both our sides. Make sure you measure how much of this you need to pull behind. So put the two tabs on. In. Like that. So I'm going to like a little bit on each side, and I'm gonna measure to see if that works for me. So I have these two parts are pretty much equidistant from each other. I'm gonna grab my knee thing, I'm gonna put it right there. I'm gonna put the, come on thing, tip of this on one side, bring this around, and this tip on the other side. I'm just kind of gonna hold it to get a sense of what the tension is. If I need to adjust it, vice versa, all right? And then once you figure out where this is that it needs to be, like how far back it needs to be, we're gonna just gonna go ahead and glue this into place and we'll be done with that. All right. So once you got your measurements more or less figured out, while you have it spread out like this, I would suggest just starting with the other one. So it's kind of like slide this in. Just make sure we even this out. All right, slide that in, put it next to your part, and just kind of pull and tug until it reaches more or less the same distance, right? And then you do that for the other side. And you continue that until you have all four pieces, okay? Also, before you even glue it, to just like avoid a lot of this fraying, you can just take like a regular just household lighter and just kind of singe the edges of your elastic a little bit, if you feel the need to. This is gonna get glued to the back anyways, but I just like to make sure things are not gonna come apart. Them, so I'll do that for all of the pieces and then just get rid of all that fuzz, make sure it doesn't come apart on me. All right. Cool. Now we have all of our pieces. To attach them to our piece. All right, so once you're ready to glue these on, these holes are actually a good indicator of where, see how the little arrow points at the hole? It's exactly where you want it. You can have it as close or as far away as you'd like. It's really up to you as far as like the look is concerned. I'm gonna have it so it has like, it's just like a couple of millimeters away from the actual part right there, all right? Or enough room that I can stick my Apple band right through it. Just do my little lines right there. Now I know where to put my glue. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. And once I'm nice and lined up, close enough, pineapple band, and we're good. My glue, I'm gonna glue the rest of these, and we will be done. All right, so both of our parts are done here, looking really nice. But you notice that, yeah, maybe this looks a little too clean compared to everything else. So again, with either your acrylic or using spray paint on a piece of plastic and then dry brushing, I'm gonna do a little bit of dry brushing with the rub and buff, and it's gonna really bring out the texture of the fiber provided with this. It's like a very techy, kind of like utilitarian type of texture. So I'm just gonna bring that back in right at the tip, along the edges, along the surface a little bit, just to get everything to feel just as used as them.